Mostly today I find the news pretty boring because most of the news is all about COVID. My attitude is all our lives we've had the chances of epidemic pandemics, and anytime you go into even a hospital for any kind of activity at all, you could end up with something called MRSA. And MRSA is sort of a communicable disease that a lot of doctors and a lot of nurses end up getting, and I'm not sure why. But openly it's brought in by something, someone, somewhere, I don't know. But I practically don't like large hospitals for that. I also don't like large hospitals and what's going on today with the Standards of Care Act, because standards of care are dramatically changing. We are now coming up with this new concept, this new bullshit in publicity of continuity of care, which means that these hospitals that are large conglomerates can take your motherfucking records and pass them across to other hospitals. There's a real problem in me for that. First of all, it's my record, not yours, and it doesn't belong across every fucking person who has to attend to me in that development of that record and the payment of my bill. I don't like the fact that when I go to pay my bill, some little secretary behind the counter knows what the fuck I might be ill with or what my issues are, because I don't like that. I don't even like that in a regular clinic. But what I'm saying to you is, even though they do these codings and things for our marvelous year-end checks or whatnot, that's not my point. My greater concern is that as a consumer, we won't have the chance or the right to do what you're supposed to do when someone says you're ill, which is to go and double-check, am I really ill, with another organization where you get your second and third opinions. We used to be really valuable about that in the society. We used to really care about that in society. But today, we're just like throwing it out the window, like everybody's super honest about what they do in medicine, and that's just not true. I've been monkeyed with by so many fucking Muslims in the medicine and the mental health industry, it's not even funny. And those situations, I didn't ask to be in. I didn't ask to be in those situations, I didn't choose those people as my physicians, and that was a total violation of my human rights. International Human Rights Declaration is a treaty that is really quite mighty, and it's really what we should be using across our land. I don't know why we have all these local city ordinances. I don't know why we have all these local state requirements, because frankly, the federal laws are enough for us. If we can get people to just understand the fucking federal laws and the amendments, then we would just have a safe society, I would think. We have failed our children to not teach these things in elementary school, remind them of it through junior high and high school, and then replant it in their minds in college. We need more ethics classes, we need more society classes, we need more history classes to remind these people where the fuck they came from. I have made a statement today that probably will get people monkeyed with, but the absolute truth is that we came across the sea from Europe, from England, to basically be able to practice our my country, tis of thee, meaning we are interested in sweet land of liberty, and we are interested in the home of the brave and home of the free, but we're most interested in the ability to play with our own God the way we choose to. We came here to worship God our own way. We wanted to get away from the Catholic Church. We wanted to get away from the requirements of different countries and their different environments that were literally being abused in a way, but used in a way, and yet married in a way. From different nations would marry different queens and kings to each other so that they were more in control of the world. What I'm talking about today, of course, is truth. That American, as a continent, came here, and they were predominantly pilgrims from New England, which basically meant that the English came over and created New England, which meant that we came into a society of Native Indians. The Native Indians of American land are the true Americans of America. But the reality is that we have horribly, out of our need and out of our greed and out of our study of science and technology, have totally abused them. But we're getting back to understanding our roots, our spirituality, and how important the land is, how important our ancestors are here. But the bottom line is that the whites developed it here. Everybody else has been a fucking import. And no offense to anyone who's not of the white color or Caucasian race, but if you're black here, you are imported here. And no offense to anyone who came from Europe or Russia or Jamaica or anyone else who's come in since then from India or East Asia, like my late spouse who came from a Japanese place. But my point is that in life, we have to recognize the truth and the history of America. And that is, we came here to worship. So if you don't want to fucking worship God, get the fuck out. We are a nation of worshipers. The problem is, what are we worshiping now? Worshipping technology, we're worshipping movies, we're worshipping movie stars, we're worshipping everything that is not healthy for us. We're worshipping food. Americans are apparently some of the most overweight people in the world, but part of that is our proclivity to food, but it's also the way that we waste food, that we just think it grows on trees. Well, frankly, it does, but the point is that we just throw it out, and we don't care for food. We have food handlers that are disgusting with food. We have food handlers that abuse our food. We have food handlers that try to change what we want when we order our food, and that pisses me off to no end, because that is a theft of money. That is a theft of, well, our rights, and that is a theft that should not be happening at all if you know what you're doing in that world.